So we're assuming that we've got this ready, aim, fire thing kind of working. We've got code that whenever we run it, that it puts in a velocity and an angle and it goes meow and we've got it. So this is really exciting because it actually works. So one of the things that we'd like to do to make this more fun is to actually make it look like it's going like this, like actually firing instead of just plotting it. We'd actually like to see it fire. So what we're going to do is we are going to, instead of plot it, we are going to do a comet, which is just kind of a cool little thing you can do in MATLAB, where if I put in a 33 and a 33 and hit fire, it'll go pew like that. So it's actually kind of fun. Now that said, I can tell that if I'm having to run this a whole bunch, on an opening guide, I'm going to get really bored typing in answers and running it. So to make my life easier, I'm going to preset some values for the velocity and for the angle, just so that I have something to do and not have to work so hard. So now whenever I run it, it will already be in there and all I have to do is hit fire, and it's exciting. And I don't know why. I know there's a way to control where this shows up on your screen, so I have to keep dragging it over, but for the moment, I'll just leave it the way it is. Okay, so we've got that. That's exciting. I'm going to say, okay, well, maybe the next thing we'd like to do is to set an actual target for it to aim at. Now, we could just randomly select where we want this to be. I don't feel like this is sufficiently complicated that I need to do it outside of MATLAB, so I'm going to go ahead and do it here. So that's kind of how you work through it. You think, well, if I feel comfortable like I knew exactly what I'm doing, I'm going to go ahead and do it in the GUI. If I feel a little bit uncomfortable, I might take it outside the GUI and run it from there. So I feel pretty good about it. I'm going to say that I want that target to be some random distance away. I'm going to call it rand from, let's see, how do I want to do this? Let's say that I want it to be a random number. So how far out? Let me see actually how far out this is going automatically, because I kind of like the way this looks. It's going out about 70, so I'm going to say I want a random number from 55 to, 150. So we'll say from 50 to 150, and that sounds good, except I can't spell random. So right quick, pause the video, see if you can remember how to create a random number from 50 to 150, because it's good practice. All right, let's assume that's happened. So basically, I'm going to shift it by 50, because that's the low end, and I'm going to scale it by 150 because that's how far, or by 100 because that's how far apart they are. So 150 minus 50 is 100. I did that backwards. So I'm going to scale it by 100 and then I'm going to add 50. And so that's where my target's going to be. So I also want to plot. So now I'm going to come down here. I'm going to plot. It's going to be target out and it's going to be zero up because it's going to be on the ground. I'm going to say hold on. That's going to prevent it from erasing the comet that's going to plot next, and then I'm going to turn that. So I've got this, and that's amazing. Oh yeah, it's because I went 0.55 instead of, wait, this doesn't even make sense at all. It's like 55 over, and then it's like, not. I don't know where my target is. You know what, I probably can't even see my target. So let me try something else. Maybe I did need to do this outside of MATLAB or outside of the GUI. So I'm going to try that. I'm going to take this same code that I thought was working, except the velocity and angle, because I'm getting that from somewhere else. So I'm going to take all this back over here, and I'm going to see what's going on. So I'm going to go troubleshoot it outside of the GUI. So there that is. All right. This is amazing. And I'm going to unsuppress target so I can actually see what it's going to be. Okay, so right now my target's at 62, and my plot is missing. There. So my target's at 62, and I can't see it. All right, so I need to think about another way to plot this. So I need to go get help from plot. Okay, all righty. Okay, so I could change the marker size, marker color, and stuff like that. So let me try plotting the marker size at, like, 10 or something like that, and see what that's going to give me. So instead of just, I didn't do this right there. Instead of plotting that, I'm going to go ahead and plot it with a marker size of 10 and just see if that makes a difference. So let's run that. Ooh, no, that did not help. Okay, my target was at 141. I still don't see it. All right, maybe that wasn't big enough. Am I doing X's and Y's right? Yeah, I totally am. I'm not crazy. All right, what if I specifically, what else can I do? I can change the shape of it. So let's change the shape of it to a, what are the options? Let's change it to a diamond. All right, so let's change it to a diamond so that maybe it's easier to see. All right, run it again. There it is. Okay. That was a good thing to happen. Okay. Now what's happening is it looks like that my axis is going from 0 to 0.2. I'm thinking it's because I'm plotting this first and that it's like scaling the plot based on my initial thing. So maybe what I want to do is I actually want to change the axis. So I have to remember how to do this. Axes? Axes and arbitrary, no, it must be axis. Okay, axis. There, that's how I can control the axis. Okay, so it looks like I'm going to want to control the axis. So axis, x min, it's going to go from 0 to something, and the y is going to go from 0 to something. Okay. Okay, so I've got that. Now let's see, for the x max, it's going to be the maximum of this guy. Well, actually, it's either going to be the maximum of that, or it's going to be the maximum of the target. So let's say, we'll just say we want it to be at target, say, plus maybe 25% more of the target for the x-axis. And then for the y-axis, well, I guess it's just going to depend. I don't want to replot it every time I shoot the cannon, so maybe I'll just kind of pick something randomly to be sufficiently far away, so maybe I'll just make it the same thing. I don't know, no particular reason. So let's just try that and see if that works. And stupid plot thing there. Okay. Okay. Well, I know why that's happened. There we go. Okay, so now I've got this, and then I've got that, and so that seems a little tall. Just because of what it would take to actually get there. So maybe I won't make it quite that big. And this is all, you know, you just make it up as you go, and that's okay because, you know, code. All right, so there we go. That's kind of looking better-ish. Why did it stop? I don't remember. That's pretty good. There we go. Oops. Why did it go away whenever I move the figure? Are y'all seeing that happen too? That wasn't just me, right? Okay, so it's there, I move the figure, and then it moves. So that's cool. Alright, that's alright. I'm at least sufficiently confident they've got something going on here. So let's just go with that. Okay, so now I'm going to take this code, again, except for the getting of the velocity and the angle, and I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to copy this over into Ready Aim Fire. So I'm just going to replace that code, just completely replace what was already there. Okay, so I've got this velocity, and I'm going to pop this out so you can make sure that you have the same thing that I do. I'm going to, delete this green stuff because it's freaking me out. All right, so basically I've got where I'm going to go get the velocity off of the GUI. I'm going to get the angle off the GUI. I'm going to randomly make a target. I've got this time set out so that I can find the x and y position. I'm going to find the good values where y is greater than 0 so that I'm not, you know, plowing the cannonball deep into the Earth's core. And then I've got the good y's based on that and the good x's. I'm going to plot the target, and then I'm going to plot trying to hit it. And I can already see the flaw in this plan, but that's okay. I'll go ahead and save it, and I'm going to run it. So, pew, pew. Okay, that was amazing. That was really cute. Hold on. So, I see a basic problem here, which is that every time I plot it, it keeps adding a new target. And I can't imagine a funner game to play than to constantly be changing the target every time you try to hit something, okay? So that tells me that I need to move the place where the target is created. So right now, I'm creating the target every time I push the function button, which is probably not the best thing. So really what I need to do is I'm going to take that target and I'm going to move it up to whenever I open the function. So whenever I open the function, I'm actually going to come over here. I'm going to create the target. Okay, so in the opening function of the GUI, I'm going to create the target. I'm also probably going to go ahead and plot it. That seems like a good idea. So I'm going to hope that nothing weird goes on. So this is something I can't practice outside the GUI. The only way I can practice this is inside the GUI. All right, so I'm going to see if this works. Don't get excited. Okay. Oh my gosh, look, there's a target. That's amazing. And then I go choo, and I go choo, and I go choo, and I go choo. Let me change my velocity just to see what happens now. Oh, overshot. I kind of got close, and that was poor. 33, choo, and 34. Okay, I got it. Yay! I hit the target. Nothing happened, but I hit the target. So this is very, very exciting. Let's see if we can do more of stuff involving what do we do when we actually hit the target, and I'll go ahead and put that in the next video.